of believers' authority.
Hallelujah. Understanding and walking under the grace of the believer's authority. 2 Corinthians 10, 3 to 5, our God scriptures, and Luke 10, 17, 19. 2 Corinthians 10, 3 to 5, says what?
For though we walk in the flesh,
as mortal men,
we are not carrying on spiritual warfare according to the flesh.
According to the flesh.
And using the weapons of man.
And using the weapons of man.
The weapons of our warfare.
The weapons of our warfare
are not physical.
They are not physical.
Weapons of flesh and blood.
Weapons of flesh and blood.
Our weapons are divinely powerful.
Our weapons are divinely powerful.
For the destruction of the fortress.
For the destruction of the fortress.
We are destroying sophisticated arguments.
We are destroying sophisticated arguments.
And every exalted and proud thing.
And every exalted and proud thing.
That sets itself up against the true knowledge of God.
That sets itself up against the true knowledge of God.
And we are taking every thought.
And we are taking every thought captive.
Amen.
Amen.
And purpose captive.
And purpose captive to the
obedience of Christ.
To the obedience of Christ. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Go to Luke 10, 17, 19.
Luke 10, 17.
Luke 10, 17.
The 70 returned with joy.
The 70 came back with joy.
Saying, Lord.
Lord.
Even the demons are subject to us in
your name. Even the demons are subject to us by your name.
He said to them.
He said to them.
I watched Satan fall from heaven like a flash.
I, the Lord, I have seen Satan fall down from heaven like a flash of lightning.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
Listen carefully.
Listen carefully.
I have given you authority.
I have given you authority.
That you now possess.
That now you possess.
To tread on serpents and
scorpions. To tread on serpents and scorpions.
And the ability to exercise
authority. And the ability to exercise the authority.
Over all the power.
We pray and we give thanks. The Bible says that Jesus told the disciples, I have seen Satan fall like a lightning from heaven. But that one does not worry me. Because listen, I have given you power to stample, to trample upon serpents and scorpions. Not that I am going to go and bring you power on. I have given you power. Yes, I have seen Satan fall like lightning. Yes, I know he has fallen. But I have equipped you by your name. I don't care what you are going through. I don't care what the enemy is speaking to you. But I have to let you know that you have an authority in God the Father. You have the authority in God the Father. You have the authority in God the Son. You have the authority in God the Holy Spirit.
I heard the servant of God say he can't die. I looked at him like this and come up, oh my God, why are you bragging? Do you know you can die? Me, I was telling him now in my speech. You cannot talk to servant of God broken. So I was talking inside. I do a only for me to realize that the power of death and life is in my tongue. That is the authority. Praise the Lord.
Okay. I used to hear some of God say, I cannot be poor.
I looked at them like this, huh? Poverty.
Praise the Lord. Read for us where I'm going to dwell today, that those scriptures, we are going to use them as we continue. But today I want us to dwell something else. I want to lay a foundation about a believer's authority. And when I'm talking about a believer, I'm not talking about a Christian. When I'm talking about a believer, I'm not talking about a Christian. I'm talking about somebody who knows they are God. They shall do by the experts. Praise the Lord. Read for me Ephesians 1:15-23. I want to start there. Says what?
For this reason.
For this reason.
Because I've heard of your faith.
Because I have heard of your faith.
In the Lord Jesus.
In the Lord Jesus.
And the love for all God's people.
And the love for all God's people.
I do not cease to give thanks for you.
I do not cease to give thanks for you.
Remembering you in my prayers.
Now, the eyes of the heart is other people are seeing. will never be closed.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. The eyes of your heart is what makes you wake up in the morning and continue living, even if you slept hungry yesterday. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The eye of your heart is your center of being.
Maybe enlightened.
Maybe enlightened. Praise the Lord. It's because you don't know your position. It is because you don't know the authority that God has given you. After this, you will walk. You will never faint. After this, you will run. You will never give up. After this, every winning battle that will come your way, you are going to win like a flash in the name of Jesus. Read for me Luke 10, 19. Those ones who pay this thing, go behind our online people are saying there's a lot of noise from the children. Go behind, we bless the Lord.
Luke 10:19.
Listen carefully.
I've given you authority.
Hey, Jesus, I love this. I love that scripture. I love it with the whole of my heart. Jesus was not saying, I have gone for authority. To you, do your hands like this. Say, I got it.
Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Make man in our image.
Make man in our own image.
According to our likeness. Not physical.
Not physical.
But our spiritual personality.
Tell your neighbor, mimi ni kamuni, I am a God. Tell your neighbor, I am a God.
Yani, Mungu alisema, akaita Roho Mtakatifu, akaita Mwana, na yeye, akasema, wacha tuumbe mwanadamu, akiwa na mfano wetu, sio katika sura, lakini kiroho. Praise the Lord. So you are a God.
There are some conditions you can look in your house like this. You say, I command creation. I command creation. I command creation. I command creation.
You are God. That is the power you carry. Praise the Lord. You can go to your bank account and speak to it. I command. Now listen. Why are you looking at me like that? I have a story. And this man was this man, I believe I'm going to remember the story shortly. This man was a spiritual son of Benson Idahosa. Do you know Benson Idahosa?
Yeah.
He was a spiritual son of Benson Idahosa. And so there were two guys. They traveled to Africa. They came to do business. And the business they were doing is the business of good news. And so they knew for us to spread the gospel, we need a car. So they bought a car. And when they bought a car, because they wanted a four-wheel drive, ya kuingia mashinani, they bought a big car. So the car was on loan. So wakalipa. Ikafika mahali, injini ikakuwa ngumu sana mpaka wapewe offering. So they were going dry. The bank started calling them. They were called, we need to pay. The day that the bank was supposed to come and pull the car, these guys went into prayer. They said, the God of our father Benson in the house, we pray as we wake up in the morning. Oh God, remove this shame. We need to get money to pay this car. Because you know this car, we don't know what we need to eat. This car is all about the ministry. We pray when we wake up. We don't care what will happen. We just want money. When they woke up in the morning, they got money all over in the sitting room. In dollars. Herika. We are gods. Speak to your situation. Create. They created a bank. They became bankers. They owned money. They even had to rent a house. A big one. They invited other people. Come, we do ministry. Life is becoming easy.
I pray for you as you exercise your authority. You are going to start in me with a new business. In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
I went, nikatembea, hata sikubebwa na buda, nikatembea nikiongea, nikasema, Father,
I am a God. You have given me power to dominate, to for multiplication. My God and my Father multiply in your own ways. By the time I enter the bank like this, let me get the exact money that I need. My God and my Redeemer. I went. When I reached the bank, nikacheka na huyo attendant. Kambia, hi, kopoa, I have come. Kambia, na by the way, kabla haujaenda kutoa pesa, ebu kuja. Kuna mzazi amelipia watoto wake school fees ya whole year. Nikamuza. In fact, right now the check has just cleared. You are family bank? Now we're in your family bank to make clear the check. The account right now has 58,000.
Hey! I was like, my Father, my God, you are my multiplier. You become a God!
And that's why I was really to Nanikato. Usinuza nifanya nini. And you do it. Praise the Lord. You know what? When you have to multiply. That you have crowned him with honor and glory. Eh?
You've made him to have dominion.
You have made him to have dominion
over the works of your hand.
Over the works of your hand.
You have put all things under his feet.
You have put all things under his feet.
That is your authority. Amen. That slave queen who is bothering your marriage is under your feet. Amen. That devil that you think is so powerful is under your feet. He may be powerful to others, but not to a believer.
Praise the Lord. Amen. That is the authority. It was given to you free. Fact number two about a believer's authority.
It was legally lost by man. That is the sad part. Now that is where some of the Christians are. What Christianity
to me means that proper authority was lost. Na sasa shetani anatukandamiza. Roho anatumiapiga kasema anakaambia, "Kai pastor, please pray for me. Mimi ninasikia kama nitaisha." Aki shetani amenigandamiza. Ushikie kwa namna hiyo. Aki pastor mimi hata sijui. Aki mimi nasikia nimeelemewa. There are people who are believers and that is where they have sat. I want you to know that the authority was rightfully given to Satan by man, not God. So it means the intention of God from the beginning of the book of Genesis still prevails.
Amen.
The authority that Satan has now was given to him by man, not God.
Read for me Ephesians 2, 1 to 3.
Says what?
And you, he made alive when you were spiritually dead.
When you are dead, God made you alive.
And separated from him because of your transgressions.
Because of your sins and your transgressions. The Lord, the thing that made the authority go to men, and they are not experiencing the authority in power, is because of sin. Praise the Lord.
In which you once walked.
You
are following the ways of this world. Influenced by this present age. In accordance to the prince of the power of the air.
That is Satan.
The spirit who is now at work.
The spirit that is at work right now.
In the disobedient. They are unbelieving. Who fight against God's
purpose. Purposes.
Among these unbelievers. We all once lived in the passions of our flesh. Our behavior governed by the sinful self. Indulging the desires of human nature.
Yes.
Without the Holy Spirit. And the impulses of this sinful mind. We were by nature
children
under the sentence of God's wrath.
Yes.
Just like the rest of mankind.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The authority was taken away from us because of sin. Since we are here, we are here, Shetan authority.
This happened in the Garden of Eden.
Praise the Lord. When Adam and Eve sinned, they took the authority that was put on them. They gave Satan. Can I hear somebody say amen?
Amen.
Now, what Satan failed to do in heaven, he tried doing it. He tried bringing it to us. That's the reason why Satan wanted to be what in heaven?
I am teaching a church. This church is a teaching church. Satan wanted to be what in heaven? He wanted to be like God. Is that true? He wanted to be like God. Na kwa sababu alipatikana, akashushwa, akakosa kufanana na Mungu. Wakati alikutana na Eve, alimwambia aje, if you eat this fruit, you will be like God.
The same thing that Satan did in heaven and he never accomplished, now he used man to do it.
He looks for somebody to accomplish. And the reason why? Because Satan wanted to have that egometric. He wanted to become a man. He told Jesus, change this bread. Take this stone into bread. He wanted to change the egomantic of God. He wanted to know your mutu. And Jesus was very smart. Jesus said, it is written, man shall not live on bread alone. Akaona, uja man ajua. Akataka Jesus to break the law. Akampeleka kwa mlima. Akamwambia niabudu tu. Hakuna wimbo ya shetani. Hakuna. It's only the ring. Sana kitu yake is a thief.
That is a thief. He has had a yesu.
Hizi vitu zote nimepewa na nani? Go back to the scripture, read. Ona ni nani alimpea, hakuwa kitu. But now he pretends he has authority. Now that's the reason why, when they wanted him to break the law, Jesus never broke the law. When the devil wanted Jesus to please his own body, Jesus never did that. Jesus conquered. Praise the Lord. Amen. To bring back the authority. Now, that's why I do this. He knew, I am going to use the second Adam. Because the Bible calls Jesus the second Adam. I am going to use the second Adam to go my way. Oh, the second Adam will take your authority for me. Your man has been like a man. He wanted, can you say, yes, we're fine. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Have you ever asked yourself, why was Jesus born by a woman? Because if Jesus is the Son of God, God has been drawn. See, I am drawn. Why was Jesus born by a woman? By the conception of the Holy Spirit. Listen. The reason why Jesus was born by a man, a virgin woman, is because Jesus was 100% man and Jesus was 100% God. And that's why Jesus could not have been born from the lineage of Adam. Why? Satan could have accused him. So Jesus had a father who is God and a mother who is a woman who was 100% human. I want to let you know that Jesus never, God never defeated Satan as God. God defeated Satan as man. The same authority that God had given Adam is the same authority that Jesus used to defeat Satan.
I don't know who I'm about to speak to. Assurance from the lineage of the believer's side. Not even can stand your way. The same authority that Jesus left in the Garden of Eden, it is still active for you. It is still active for your children. It is still active.
That is why, if Jesus came in form of a spirit, tukakuwa tukisema, Yesu alishinda shetani kwa sababu, Jesus had to become a man. He went through what you and me are going through to show us that power is still active.
Praise the Lord. To show us that power is still active. I am somebody saying it.
But you know what? The same war that was introduced in heaven, the same war came here. And that's what the Bible says. I have seen Satan fall like a lightning. On earth, if the people are going to go, I will let them go. Now, geographically, I can position in people's hearts. And this is why Christians are giving up. And this is why Christians are committing suicide. Why? They don't know the power they have.
Praise the Lord.
If Jesus defeated Satan as a man, I can defeat and bury him.
I can defeat and live with him. Praise the Lord. Jesus was a man like me and you. He defeated Satan. Lastly, most of the Christians are stagnated there. People know the power was taken away. Satan is all powerful. Satan is all glorious. He's a lie from the devil. He may be powerful, but he's under our feet. Why? Authority was given to the believers.
But why are we are believers? He should not speak. He should be silent. Praise the Lord. Number three, and the last one.
The authority was regained righteously by Christ.
Number two, it is a fact that the authority was given to Satan by man. It's a fact.
But number three, another fact, is that the same authority that the devil got that we got was brought back to man righteously.
So it is yours for taking. Praise the Lord. Read for us. We have read Ephesians 17. Ephesians 1:17.
I always pray.
I always pray.
the God of our Lord Jesus Christ,
yes,
the Father of glory,
uh-huh,
may grant you a spirit of wisdom,
yes,
and of revelation,
uh-huh,
that gives you a deeper and personal and intimate insight,
yes,
into the true knowledge of Him.
Into the true knowledge of Him.
For we know the Father and the Son.
Praise the Lord. That is what was brought back. That is the thing. So if you see a believer walking and saying, I cannot die of cancer, I refuse to die of cancer, I cannot die, he knows the authority that he got. Praise the Lord. He knows.
That is why the Bible says that by the flesh, by blood and flesh, the authority was lost. By blood and flesh, the authority was brought back. Praise the Lord. By blood and flesh. That's the reason why Jesus, when Jesus was coming here to die, they never used anything else. They used a man. Just the way the authority was taken by a man, a man had to come and bring back the authority.
Praise the Lord. Read for us. Hebrews 2:14. The flesh of the blood brought authority. The flesh of the blood brought it back. Hebrews 2:14.
Therefore, since these his children share in flesh and blood,
yes,
the physical nature of mankind,
the physical nature of mankind,
he himself,
in a similar manner,
also shared the same physical nature
but without sin.
So that's through experiencing death.
So that through experiencing death,
he might make powerless. Ineffective and impotent. He who had the power of death. That is the devil.
Praise the Lord. And am I talking to a church?
Yes.
Am I talking to a church?
Yes.
You know, Satan saw all these things and said, I've got the authority in my hands. I'm good from it. Now Jesus saw. And Jesus, because he wanted us to continue reigning, Jesus wanted us to continue walking in victory. Now Jesus came and gave us the power. I don't know if I'm to speak to you tonight, but I've got to let somebody know that whatever the devil thought he was doing it for man, Christ began the victory. Christ began the victory. When he submitted our master Jesus, the authority was brought back to us. He put a crown of God on his head.
But when they took Jesus and they buried my master, They thought it was finished.
But you are giving my master a channel, a father, to go and make the keys of hell.
In the book of Numbers 21:49. Hallelujah, Jesus Christ. I am walking in victory. I am a believer. I am a believer. When I'm going to talk things here, next Sunday I'll be teaching things here about your authority over your health.
By the way of the branch of the Red Sea.
Yes.
To go around the land of Israel.
Yes.
And the people became impatient.
The people became impatient
because of the challenges of the journey.
Yes.
So the people spoke against them, against Moses. Why have you brought us out of Egypt to die in the wilderness?
Yes.
For there's no bread. Now is there any water?
Yes.
And we know this miserable food.
Yes.
Then the Lord sent fiery burning serpents amongst the people.
Amongst the people.
And they beat the people.
And they beat the people.
And many Israelites died.
And many Israelites died.
So the people came.
The coronavirus was sent. And many people died. I want to show you the secret.
So the people came to Moses.
The people came to Moses
and said,
We have sinned.
We have sinned. For we have spoken against the Lord.
For we have spoken against the Lord.
And against you.
Against you.
Pray to the Lord.
Pray to the Lord.
So that he remove the serpents from us.
So that he remove the serpents from us.
So Moses prayed for the people.
Prayed for the people.
Then the Lord said to Moses.
Moses was given prophetic instruction.
Make a fiery serpent.
Make another serpent of bronze. Yes.
And set it on a pole.
And set it on a pole.
And everyone who's beaten.
And everyone who is beaten.
Will leave when he looks at it.
When he looks at it, they're going to leave.
So Moses made a serpent of bronze.
So Moses did that.
And put it on the pole.
And put it on the pole.
And it happened that if a serpent had beaten.
And it happened that when the serpent looked at them.
When he looked to the bronze past serpent.
Yes.
He lived.
Now read for me John 3:14-15. I want to close with that one. John 3:14-15. Let me tell you one thing. If only you know what you carry. Utakuwa tu kiomba job inakuja. Unatamani kufanya kazi kwa kampuni fulani unapata.
Just as Moses lifted up the bronze.
Just as Moses lifted up the bronze up
in the desert.
In the desert.
On a pole.
On a pole.
So must the man.
Whoever believes in me
have eternal life.
After physical death,
we
will live forever. Stand on your feet in the name of Jesus. I want somebody just to decree and declare. I receive back my authority. I receive back my authority in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, the devil got her.
Jesus, I'm going to say, 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 I' authority.
The believer's authority.
Yes.
If only you know what you carry. If you know what you carry, there are some things that will never drain you. There are some things that will never bring you down. They thought they were killing our master. They nailed him on a cross. And they did it on a mountain so that our master can suffer shame. Little did they know, as the man of son of man is lifted,
yes,
as we look unto him, no disease can bring me down.